Shall we move on then to another round, which I think we'd all use by this point?
Yes, Thomas Vinterberg's Another Round. The original Danish name is Druk, which translates to English as binge drinking, which is certainly more direct than the rather euphemistic English title. It tells the tale of a small group of high school teachers. During a birthday dinner for one of their number, the group discuss the idea proposed by the Norwegian psychiatrist Finn Skurderud that human beings naturally have too little alcohol in their bloodstream, and that maintaining a blood alcohol content of 0.05% leads to increased happiness and creativity. The next morning, one of the members, Mads Mikkelsen's Martin, decides to experiment with the concept, bringing some vodka along with him to school. Martin, who had been depressed and flailing, if not outright failing, in both his marriage and his job, finds himself liberated and re-energised. After this, Martin and his friends, Nikolai, Tommy and Peter, make a pact to all attempt the experiment, with the goal of writing a paper on the results. Oh, and they'll never drink after 8 p.m. A limit inspired by Ernest Hemingway, someone for whom things worked out really well. Experience with being human will tell you that this is not likely to end well, with the alcohol experiment causing some problems, masking other problems, and revealing others still. And maybe, just maybe, mind, teachers drinking well at school isn't a brilliant idea? Another Round definitely has some comments to make, beginning as it does with teenagers getting drunk in a park. In Denmark, you can buy beer or wine from the age of 16, so it's not a legality problem. And the observation by Martin's wife, Annika, Maria Bonnevie, that this whole nation drinks like maniacs anyway. But what might surprise you to learn is that this is really a funny and at times uplifting and feel-good movie. It's tragicomic, and certainly bittersweet, but it's warm and made me laugh a lot. It's driven by an excellent central performance by Mads Mikkelsen, who I'm not sure I've ever actually seen act in Danish before.
Yeah.
With a small, solid supporting cast, including the aforementioned Bonnevie. Incidentally, Maria Bonnevie played the hotel receptionist Insomnia, making this one of those weird coincidences where you see someone in nothing ever, then in two unrelated films almost back to back, and Tim Key's Danish cousin.
Yes, literally, yes.
Yes. While I mentioned that Another Round has something to say, it's not much, as it's quite a flippant film with a premise based on what could charitably called questionable science, but it's just a lot of fun, and that'll do me nicely. And Craig, as we've established at the beginning that I don't watch films for fun, 80% of the films of this podcast I enjoyed.
Yay.
Stick that in your pipe and smoke it.
No, I don't smoke after 8.
Yes, I liked Another Round. I don't think there's an awful lot to say about it, other than it's really nice to see Mads Mikkelsen, who obviously doesn't need to prove his acting chops in anything to anyone by this point, but it's nice to see it done in his native language, which, like you, I don't think I've seen him in anything else. I'm willing to be proved wrong on that, but I don't remember seeing him in anything that's not English language. And
yeah, I had a quick scan through his filmography, and nothing stuck out to me that I could remember having seen him in doing anything other than English, in a language in which he acts very well also, but
yes.
It's nice to see him act in Danish.
Yes, and of course there's a great affinity between the Scots and the Danes because, well, alcoholism. And yes, it's...
and being miserable.
Yes. Most of this worked pretty well. I don't know if I go so far as to say it's uplifting, given the, you know, suicides and all that, but, you know, it's funny on a number of occasions, and it's definitely interesting to see the kind of results of their experiments into alcoholism and increasing alcohol content and all that stuff, and it's frequently very funny. So yes, it definitely has that going for it. It is well acted by everyone, and frequently definitely funny enough to make it worth a recommendation on that basis alone. So yes, probably worth giving it a go.
I laughed heartily at the scene when they're stealing the bottles in the bar. The first I thought he was just held himself to drink, and then suddenly he's got two whole bottles he's just lifted off this the shelf of the bar. Just interesting you read that as a suicide, because I didn't, and I know other people have. I read that as a tragic accident just because he was so drunk and he didn't have his life jacket on.
I mean, maybe, but who can say? I mean, he was very drunk at the time, so...
I mean, it doesn't change the film much. It's just like that's not how I read it. Like, had he done that, I wouldn't be surprised. But I didn't read that actually how that happened was because of that. Again, it doesn't affect the film. I just found it just a very entertaining film. And just to prove Craig Long that I like films and watch them because I enjoy them. Yeah. This is, there's less to say about the last thing because I went on this massive screed about Wonder Woman, which I hated. I really liked Another Round, and I've had a couple paragraphs about it, and that's it. That's the problem.